Mr. Data.
Theoretically, sir, it should work.
If we do this, we have to do it fast. The Romulans will be within sensor range in less than a minute.
Make it so, Mr. Data.
Aye, sir. Initiating ionization field pulse.
When he's finished, we'll have to move away and make it look as if we've scanned the asteroid but haven't found anything.
Lay in a course for the next search grid. Stand by to engage.
If it works, the Romulans won't find anything and we can return later. If it doesn't...
If it doesn't work, we'll have handed them the Pegasus. Ionization pulse complete.
Helm, 1/4 impulse. Engage.
The Romulans are initiating a tachyon scan of the asteroid. They have switched to their lateral sensor array. Beginning another scan.
They're certainly being thorough.
The Warbird has completed its sensor sweep.
If they found the resonant signature, they should be sending away teams any second.
They are moving out.
Mr. Data, we must convince the Romulans that we're still looking for the Pegasus. I want you to continue scanning this system.
Aye, sir.
I want to be back at this asteroid at 0800 hours tomorrow. Plan your search pattern accordingly.
Aye, sir.
Admiral, would you care to join me for some late dinner?
Please excuse me, Captain, but I think I'd better turn in early.
You're the bridge number one. Oh, and will you bring the scan analysis to my quarters when you're off watch?
Aye, sir. Initiate search of grid 163.
Beginning sensor sweeps.
Commander, I want to see you in the captain's ready room.
Mr. Data, you have the bridge.
Aye, sir.
What the hell is the matter with you? Destroy the Pegasus before we've even taken a look at it?
I thought it was more important that the Romulans...
Well, you were wrong! We have a chance here to change the balance of power in this quadrant, but we can't very well do that if we destroy the Pegasus, now can we?
No, sir.
It hasn't been easy for you, I'm sure, keeping your captain and friends in the dark like this.
I haven't enjoyed it, if that's what you mean.
I hope you understand that it's necessary.
I understand that you think it's necessary.
You have changed.
Changed?
There's something the captain and I were talking about. To be honest, I'm glad to see this kind of change in you, Will. State your opinion and stand by it. It's a far cry from the young man who used to sit at my helm and worry about pressing the wrong button.
A lot of things can change in 12 years, Admiral.
Yes, they can. But it's important that a man changes the right things in his life, not his sense of duty, not his sense of loyalty.
I'd like to think that I haven't changed those things, sir.
I would like to think that, too. Because those things say more about a man than the rank on his collar or the uniform he wears. They define him. Twelve years ago, a lot of older and more seasoned officers turned away from their duty. But you stood up for what was right. I'm sorry, Will. I know the kind of man you are. I know that I can count on you again.
Come.
The scan analysis you asked for?
Thank you.
Is there something else, sir?
Yes, there is. Judge Advocate General's report, stardate 36764, subject inquiry into mutiny aboard USS Pegasus. Based on testimony from Captain Pressman and other surviving officers, the Judge Advocate believes there is sufficient evidence to conclude that certain members of the crew did mutiny against the captain just prior to the destruction of the Pegasus. Mutiny? On a Federation starship? That's shocking. It's unthinkable. And yet you've never mentioned it.
No, sir.
You know, it wasn't easy to get this report. I had to pull in quite a few favors at Starfleet just to get a look at it. It seems that it was classified by Starfleet intelligence.